We're jumping on the courts today in the new Head Sprint Pro 3.0. Let's go. Wrapped up our playtest of the Head Sprint Pro 3.0s. Now this is the fourth generation of this shoe. I was on two of the previous playtests, and for the most part, I found it to be a pretty similar shoe. When I slipped it on my feet, I thought that it had a snug medium fit. I didn't have a lot of extra room in the toe box, which was good for my narrow feet, but unfortunately there was a drift defense kind of durability story on the upper that's kind of built up, and it was kind of putting a little bit of pressure on my big toe joint. And this kind of came and went throughout the playtest. Some days it would disappear, or during a practice it would come and go, but it just never felt fully comfortable for me. But I did think the cushioning underfoot was really nice.
Yeah, for me, I thought the shoes were pretty comfortable. They were a little snug for me from the midfoot down to the toe of my wider feet. And I felt this for the first few hours of the playtest. About the third hour, I started to feel that the uppers were loosening up, and I felt really good for probably from hour three to hour six. And then after hour six, I felt the shoes opened up a little bit too much for me, and I was having to tie my shoes a little bit tighter. They were still comfortable after that point, just I was having to adjust the lacing a little bit. For me, the area that I always was having a little bit of struggle to get secure was my heel, so I did use that last eyelet and was making sure to tie it up pretty tightly around the ankles.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was gonna say too. I completely agree. The cushioning for me was very responsive, not too plush though, so I felt quick, but as you mentioned, Tiffany, I definitely felt that the heel counter was not very supportive, so I definitely wanted to use that extra eyelet. As far as the uppers, the support from the uppers was good, and I felt pretty stable in these shoes most of the time as well, but definitely utilizing that extra eyelet was an awesome choice.
Same with me, I used that extra eyelet too to get that locked in heel feel. But for me, when I did that, I also had issues when I was slipping the shoe or my feet into the shoe. I was pushing down on the cushioning in the back behind the heel, and then this caused some weird creases in it, and I felt like I never got comfortable with that back heel. But like you, I thought it was a pretty supportive shoe, and stability-wise, I felt low to the ground, so I never felt like I was gonna roll an ankle or anything.
Yeah, I actually didn't have that issue with the heel. It never folded for me, and once I had my heels tied tightly in there, I felt really secure. I didn't have any issues with support or stability. I really liked how light the shoe felt along with that low to the ground feel, so I felt pretty quick. And I never was slipping either, so I was pretty confident moving around the court.
Yeah, the traction levels were great for me as well. And as far as durability, I thought they were fairly durable for being a lighter, faster shoe. I'm not seeing much wear on mine. I don't know about you guys.
Same, I think I have 8+ hours on the shoe, and I have the white colorway with the kind of gum rubber outsole, and I thought it might wear down quicker, but I haven't seen any wear underfoot. And I was looking back at my comments of the previous ones, and I thought that the last one played a little bit heavier than its weight. I think Head did a good job and redistributed the weight, and it feels a lot lighter and quicker than I was expecting.
Yeah, I agree. I think that we all think this shoe is a nice lightweight option. It may take a little bit of break-in and tying that extra eyelet on your shoes, but overall, a nice lightweight option. For more information on this shoe or any others, please check us out at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.